welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video, I wanted to share with you guys a little bit more about my sort of Todoist usage. It's changed pretty dramatically over the last 3 or 4 months. And what I want to do today is maybe give you a sort of taster into how I sort of have been exploring it. Just before we dive in, I wanted to answer some YouTube comments. So you can always skip ahead to the Todoist part if you want, but you can stick around for these comments. I don't know whether I'm going to get any glare on my glasses here. I'm just going to grab a few comments. I had a comment from Miguel in the comments. I'm not going to try and pronounce his last name because it would go hideously wrong. But he asked, and I did put a full response back if you do want to check. It's on the Ellie calendar video. He put, I'm back on Google Calendar. Any suggestions on a calendar with tasks that works with iPhone, iPad, and has a web version? Or am I asking too much? And that's a great question. There are a lot of calendar applications out there. A lot of them don't necessarily have the task function. Some of them don't have the web function, and some of them aren't solely iOS. So it's hard when it comes to calendar apps. Of course, we all love Sunrise, and that was a great application. My recommendation to you would probably be Calendars 5 and using Google Calendar. That's personally what I use. So you can use Calendars 5 on your iPhone, iPad, and you can use the task function they have there, and also use Google Calendar for web, which is a really great calendar, and will sync if that is your native calendar application or calendar experience via Calendars 5 on your phone. What I quite like about Calendars 5 is the viewing options, and it just looks really great. But there are a few other alternatives. If you wanted to just focus solely on web stuff, then SunSama is pretty good when it comes to visually planning stuff. Or you could go for some of the default ones like Google Calendars and use Google Tasks to plot out your tasks. That's just another option. Let's find another comment. Okay, so Daniel Hertzner asks on the Google Tasks video, can I share one of my Google Tasks list with another person whereby each person will be able to review and edit the same list? Not right now. I haven't seen this function available in the application. They don't even have a web version yet, so they've almost soft launched this quite heavily. So I would just wait around for this function. I'm not even sure Microsoft To-Do has this function yet, but there is on the horizon for that application, so do stick around. I had a comment from Swagata Kandala Mandal. I'm gonna ruin names here. So they asked, does Evernote Plus option still exist? That was a good question because I actually did an Evernote versus Notion video, and actually saw while I was doing the pricing, and maybe like a week off, that the Plus pricing is now gone. You've only got your basic, which is free, and you got premium and business. So they've eliminated that one, and they've made the disconnect between those two different. I don't know whether those users who have it still are still running, but to be honest, if you wanted to get my opinion on it now, looking back, I think the Plus version was pretty much of a waste of time. It was more to capture people that were like not willing to pay the almost £50 a year price and to sort of go in the middle ground. So as you can imagine, I think that's changed. So now we've got through the comments, maybe we can dive into the good Todoist stuff. Francesco knows how to keep us in suspension. Is that how you say it? So here we are with the Todoist part. You're probably wondering, because it's quite a catchy title, Goodbye Todoist. And I have tried to hint this over the last couple of weeks. But for a total of almost 3 months, I did leave Todoist. Now, I'm going to have to take you back to maybe when I left university this time last year and moved into freelancing. And during that period of time, I had, of course, a new mission to some extent. I was doing freelancing during university, but when it came to like my projects and my tasks, they were, I guess, changed because I was able to do freelancing a lot more, could able to get my hands stuck in, if you know what I mean, and go a bit further. So as you can imagine, my sort of role changed to some extent in making it a bit more serious towards that role. So during this period of time, I think it was maybe January this year, 2018, I actually decided, I was like, okay, I'm actually going to look at experimenting with the Todoist application for a total of 3 months. And my goal with that move would essentially be to try and take myself out of the to-do list, Todoist routine in terms of my setup, and also try and understand how my workflow works now I'm working freelance full time, if that makes sense. I've been using Todoist for 4 or 5 years now. I've not been someone that's not been, switching between applications. It definitely has taken me a lot of time to get to this point. So I basically, in January, was like, okay, I need to move. I spent a couple of months working out what that application would be, and also working out what sort of timing I would do. And I decided that from sort of March time to round about now would be a good time to experiment with that application in terms of giving myself a 2 to 3 month runway with the application where I would fully dedicate my time. Now that application was Things 3, and that was Things 3 for Mac and iOS. Now I obviously narrowed it down. I looked at the likes of TickTick, a couple of other applications like To-Do, OmniFocus and things like that, but they really didn't fit my sort of setup. TickTick was very much a bit too fixed, I would say, to some extent, and also I don't think it's there just yet. I think that's another conversation, but OmniFocus and To-Do were definitely on the sort of radar. But Things 3 sort of met the balance between Todoist, but also the likes of more advanced applications like OmniFocus in terms of its sort of like, not rigid structure, but GTD elements, and also sort of visual appeal. So I decided Things 3, okay, we'd give this one a 3 month hit, and I made the jump. And after maybe 3 months, I had to make the decision, am I gonna continue this application? Of course I had plenty of time to work that out, and I've now come to a decision. For the suspense back there, I'm gonna make myself a cup of tea because I heard it click and I was like, I need a cup of tea. So, sorry for that. So in terms of actual applications that I am now currently using, I am back with Todoist. And the main reason I did go back with Todoist is because over that period of time, I felt that Things 3 actually didn't work for my sort of workflow. And I feel it worked for me in terms of like when I was doing freelance projects or work and I was like, actually this application doesn't do this for me right now. Maybe that was a combination of my long experience with Todoist and things like that. But over this period of time, over this two, three months that I've been using Things 3, I've decided, no, it's not suitable for me. So just some clarity here. I think it is important to always evaluate the tools you use. To some extent, it's almost like, you write down some to-dos on a notepad, and then after a month, you like go, okay, you know, do I like the spirals on my notepad? Do I like the style of my notepad? And you can get critical, of course, but of course it's working out the best process for you over this time. And what the one thing I'm very happy for during that experiment a period of time is that I have learned things about myself and tasks and process and general productivity to some extent about myself that I have now applied to my now routine, and it's unbelievable how that's changed my own day-to-day work. Over the last 2 weeks where I've now been back on Todoist, it's actually become so much better. And to some extent, I would say that I'm glad that I did this experiment because it's taken me out of an environment, put me back into an environment, and I've sort of have a feeling of learning and good amount of knowledge. Now, what I wanna do with you guys is from my experience of this, I've got a few videos planned. What I have planned is I have Todoist. I'm gonna do my Todoist setup video just to give you an idea of how my setup has been. I do these routine ones anyway. And it, you know, it's at almost like my fourth or fifth year that I've been using it, so it's been a fair while. I'm gonna explain my 2 months with Things 3. That's gonna be a separate video. I did like a lot of stuff in Things 3, I really did, honestly. And I didn't like some stuff, so I'm gonna go over all of that stuff. I'm gonna do a Todoist versus Things 3 video. Hopefully that will be very useful, especially because now I've actually used them in practice for work, and I wasn't even, during that Things 3 period of time, Todoist paused, literally. I obviously went through the correct procedure in taking out stuff and putting it back in, but I paused it. I'm also going to do one specifically about things that sucked in Things 3. It's going to be a wordy video. And then I'm actually looking about a video that might help you all with the process of actually switching to a new application and experimenting with that. So guys, hopefully that was a interesting overview. Technically, although this was clickbaity, it was right. I did leave Todoist for 3 months in an experimental move. That's the first time I've left it since 2012 or 13. I can't think, but it's been a long time. So yeah, 5 years-ish. So that's what I'm saying. I think it's positive sometimes, and I have felt the benefits of it. So hopefully these videos, when I get back from honeymoon, wedding on this coming Saturday, not this Saturday, next Saturday, then I actually am going to be giving you a full rundown, and it will give me a lot of time to focus. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Let me know if you're liking this format of video. Let me know in the comments what you think about Todoist and Things 3. It'd be great to hear. But without further ado, thank you very much. I'll probably catch you very, very soon. If you get a bit of outage from me, it's because I'm getting married and on honeymoon, so you might not get the fastest responses, but always leave your comments. I try and get back to them as fast as I can. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.